Good morning, students.
Good morning, sir.
My God, thanks for the response. We thought of taking classes only to computer screens, but some people also were there to listen the class. Fine. So, commencing with that, the last session was handled by Shamini ma'am. To recap that session, here we have a set of MCQs. Please respond to the questions through your options, either A or B or C or D, in the chat. So this is your first question. What is the return type of a method that does not return any value? A very basic and fundamental question. So we're getting a lot of options on C. Fine. So ultimately void. Void it returns nothing. So that could be the answer for this. Void it returns nothing. See, who created this void? I think people, the person who remained this name, Kernighan, who played a vital role in the development of C programming language as well as BCPL, the ancestral C. This person have a major role in creating this data type. Void. It means void is also a data type. While you are going to typecast any data type with this void, it can be possible. You can convert that respective data type. When you are going to work with the function pointers or pointers to function in C, the role of this void will be huge, because dynamically you can map a data type or the address of the value being referred by a void pointer can be typecasted using this void, right? So that could be a major role of this void is there. It has a lot of significance when we are going to work with pointers, but we don't have any values when we are going to work with object-oriented programming. That could be the major reason the void would not be famous in those days. Second question, which method can be defined only once in a program? So all these questions will check your fundamental idea, not to check your advanced programming skills, right? That will be analyzed only through your logical building, how you are writing your program. So what could be the answer for this? Yes. So ultimately we are getting a more number of options from A, because there could be only one main method. But while you are going to work with overloading, the faculty will teach you something on this main. Here we have strictly commencing about main method. Only one main method must be in the program. Main method is the entry point for the compiler to get into the program. That's the thing. Here you have to read something and you have to choose the option. Don't do it blindly. Go through it patiently. Which of this statement is incorrect? To test something what you have learnt in your fundamentals of OOPS. So what could be the options that we are receiving? No options. Any other recent options that could able to be? We are getting D, C, D, C. Yes, people are thinking about this, right? While on interpretation, we are ready to see. Such type of questions will validate what you have really understood. Okay. This could be the answer. Why it is? All objects of a class are allotted memory for all the variables defined in the class. We are going to see in today's session itself. Okay. Because class and object both are like a coin, two sides of the coin. Okay. If a function is defined public, it can be accessed by object of other class by inheritation. That was being elaborated. Main method must be made public. Yes, because it will ready to access function calls of all user defined functions. So ultimately A, B, C will term you true. All objects of a class are allotted memory for the methods defined in the class. Okay. That cannot be determined by the respective object. Object can point to that method, that's all. But regarding memory management, pertaining to the method will be managed only through class. Okay, so that could be the main theory behind this. That's what being understood through statement A. Question number 4. Which of these cannot be used for a variable name in Java? So we have seen rules for naming the variable. From that this question was raised. Which of these cannot be used for a variable name in Java? So what could be the option? Something is that C, B. Okay. So ultimately it could be a keyword, right? Variable name should not be used as a keyword. Keyword should not be used as a variable name. Built-in words could not be used as a variable. Okay. Identifier represents your variable only. Okay. Even function name, class name, everything will come under this umbrella, identifier. 5. Which of the below is an invalid identifier with the main method? They are asking the question, in the main method, what are all the keywords you will use? That should be filtered and you have to identify the keyword that will not use with the main method. What is the keyword that you will not use with the main method? That is what they are asking. So you know the signature of the main method, right? Remember the signature of the main method. From that, what is the one that you have not come across? So what could be the options you are posting? D. My God. Why it would be D? Because you don't know about that, right? Still we have not covered it, how it could be. What is the purpose of final? Do you know that? If I am going to use final before a class, ultimately, or before a method, you cannot create an object for it, or you cannot access that method. It would be sealed. Okay, that's the role of final along with a method or class. If I am going to use final keyword before a method or class, you cannot access that method outside the class. But what is the role of our main? Main must be made as public. It must be available in all the places, right? So that point, that built-in point would be violated here, right? So that's the idea here. And ultimately, the answer is C, private. So in the previous statement itself, I have conveyed that main method must be made public. What's the signature of the main method? Public, static, void, main. Okay. So public is available, static is available. So you are getting confused with the private and final. Because final is the word that we have not come across till now. So that's the reason why these two words are being that you have not come across till now. That's the reason why that you are getting to be confused. Private, nothing but the method must be available within that class itself. So it is not possible, right? So main method must be visible to everyone. For example, you are creating 100 classes. For all the 100 classes, main method must be visible, because main method is the one which will call all those classes and methods or variables which are available within that respective 100 classes. So for that, main method must be always public. Okay, so private is the only option. Private is the only option that we should not use with the main method. That is the main idea, right? So by that we have made a quick recap on this. Now, the place that where we have left. There are three types of variables in our Java: local variable, instance variable, static variable. Okay, and we'll see it one by one. What about this local variable? I'm going to write a addition of two numbers program. I'm going to use variables A, B, C. A, I'm going to receive a value. B, I'm going to receive a value. By adding A and B, I'm going to store it in C. So all those three variables are available within my main method. Okay, that's going to be my local variable. What is this instance variable? That's what we are going to see in terms of object. So what I will do, I will create an object. Using that object, I will access the contents of the class. That's what your instance variable. You will see it in the forthcoming slides. Static variable. What is static variable? Static variables must be used within the static methods only. You might have studied in your C programming language. You have studied four types of storage classes: auto, extend, register, static. Okay. The purpose of static variable is it will remember during a function call, it will remember what is the value stored in that variable during the previous function call, right? So it is ready to remember what is the value stored in the previous function call. It could able to remember. Okay, I will show you demonstration also for static. Okay, so there are three types of variables: local, instance, static. Local variables are normal variables that you are using within the methods, that is visible within that limit only. Next, instance means that the object what you are going to create for the class. So that is going to serve as an instance variable. Third one, static variable. So it will ready to remember the value of the previous function call. That is the usage of static. And another limitation for static is static variables must be used within the static function only. So that's the three types of variables. So I want to compare it here. The three types of variables are here. Instance variable, so how it will be given all through the class except in static methods until the object is available in the memory. So you need to see the scope and lifetime. Okay, you need to see the both scope and lifetime. So across the class that you could be able to access. So I could be able to create and delete the object. For creating the object, the operator that what I will use is new. I think people will remember in C and C++ that even in C++ this new keyword was introduced. In C, the corresponding keyword for new. Anyone could be able to type it in chat? What is the corresponding keyword for new in C? Because new keyword is not available in C language. What is the corresponding keyword for new in C language? Anyone? Could be able to type it in the chat? I want to see the answer. What is the corresponding keyword new in C language? Because in C language, new keyword is not available. What is the purpose of new? It is used to allocate the memory dynamically for an object. So likewise, what we will do in C language? What is the keyword we will use? Any answers in the chat? Yes. People are typing roll number. Why? Alloc. Yes. Ahmed, have an answer. Alloc, very good. It's good to hear that. But tell me the exact function. Yes. Right. So it could be malloc or calloc. Okay. That's the thing, Ahmed. Very good. Very good response. Okay. That it would be MLOC or CLOC. That could be the best answer for this. But alloc could be the header file, alloc.h. Okay. So that is something interesting that we are traveling with it. Class variable. Okay. So it can be accessed across the class. Until the end of the program, it would be available. So the lifetime of the instance variable and the class variable are being deferred. Okay. So that's the difference here. Finally, local variable. So local variable is nothing but within the block that I'm going to use. So until the control leaves the block, it will expire. Okay. For example, I'm going to write a method. Within that method, again, I'm putting a curly brace and I'm mentioning some variables. Those things will not be visible for the outside environment. Only within that curly brace only it will live. Okay, so here I have not talked about that the thing that what we have seen in the previous slide, static. Okay, that's the reason why here I am trying to compensate through class and instance. So you should not differ between those things. Okay, instance and the class, so both of them will differ in a place. Okay, so one variable is talking about object, one variable is talking about the declaration alone. For example, class name, object, semicolon, that's all. Okay, so if I am going to allocate memory, class name, obj, its object name equal to new class name, that will talk about the dynamic allocation. That is the place instance variable and class variable will differ. Next, after variable. So variable is the one that will change during the program execution, but constant is the one which will not change throughout the program execution. Okay, it will not change. So there are two types of constants in Java: numeric constant, non-numeric constant. Again, in numeric constant, we are having two classifications: integer constants, real constants. While we are coming for non-numeric constants, character constants and string constants. So what are all those things? So while data type is being dealt towards you, you will understand in some more fashion. But anyway, here I have supplied you some examples. Okay. So what would be the integer constant? So even again, I am classifying on that. So that could be decimal integer constant. These are all talking about number system, base 10. That is what decimal number system. Octal integer constant, nothing but base 8. Hexadecimal integer constant, that will be represented through base 16. Okay, so whenever I'm going to face small x or capital X in a number, so please remember that from this you will get questions in your campus interview. Okay, so remember this, make a mark on your note. So capital X or small x could be appended, could be prefixed with your numbers. That will talk about that the number is a hexadecimal number, and you could be able to find numbers in 3, octet of 3 or octet of 4. So in that case, you could not see any numbers greater than 8 of an individual digit. So because the octal number system will work from 0 to 7. Okay, so that could be the combination of those numbers, octal integer constant. So decimal integer constant, that is going to travel to the base 10, 0 to 9. But you could be able to find out from the given numbers. Real constant. So real constant means that we are going to work with the fraction part. Scientific notation. Okay, so that can be done through in all these fashions. Okay, so for example, you could be able to see minus 2.0, minus 2.15, and minus 0.71, plus 0.5, 0.40234, and how it can be interpreted. Minus 0.22 into 10 to the power minus 5. That could be represented like this. Okay, so capital E or small e, that could be based upon the notation. Okay, so these are all things will come under your real constant. Character constant means only characters. So it could be even small a to z or capital A to z that we are going to work with. It will not change, right? Even special characters that you could be able to embed here. String constant, so nothing but it will be represented within double quotes. That's the main difference between character and a string. See, these are all fundamentals you have come across in all the programming languages. But the thing is, in campus interviews, they will check you on these fundamentals very clearly. Okay, so please remember that. In the next session, I am going to post you some these types of questions in the recap section. So please get to prepare on that. Okay. So this could be the examples. Character and string can be differentiated by the single quote and double quotes. So real constants will speak about fractional parts. So integer constant, we have talked about number systems. As well as I can suggest you, even if you want to create your own number system, for example, you are going to create a number system base 12. Yes, you can. Okay. So that can be supplied over on that. So depending upon your convention, you can create your own number system and you could be able to use it in the integer constant. So the Java is ready to accept it. Okay. Right. Today's class regarding the object orientation, I want to introduce here two things. One is class, second one is object. Right? This could be like some nursery class, okay, by putting all these things. So animal could be your class. So what are all those objects? Animal is a very big universal set. So what are all the corresponding subsets of that universal set? That could be any type of the thing. Okay, so I could be able to see some giraffe, deer, dog, elephant, and it could be a lion also. But you could be able to see there is a bird, right? Between them, you could be able to see, right? So already I said animal could be the superset. So if I want to work with that superset, or if I want to create a derivatives of that animal, I could be able to use these objects to represent that only this diagram has been given, right? So crossing with that. What a class can contain. So class is a container which consists of member functions and member variables according to C++. Likewise in Java, class is a container which contains methods and variables. So the term function is replaced with a method in Java. So please remember that. So class can contain all these things: constructors, variables, methods, interface. So we will see what is interface, right? Nested class means class within the class, okay? Blocks, individual content available within the curly brace. All those things are available within the class. So these are all the components of the class. Whichever necessary, we can plug and play and use. That's it, okay? It is not mandatory that you have to use everything in the class always. It is as per your use that you could be able to combine and use. But I want to convey you here that variables and methods has to be used. So that's what the term class and object is being combined together to bring out a new term called encapsulation, the process of binding data with the code. That's what encapsulation. Okay, so class and object will serve you more better compared to that. So this could be the components of the class. We will see all those things in the forthcoming sessions, because if I'm going to explain everything on that, most of the classes will be shrinked. Okay, you will see in detail. These are all the components of the class that we are going to see. Again, I want to derive something with the class and the objects in a skeptical way. So see that I'm having a class called car. Okay, what are all the members of that class? Okay, there are two members. First one is the variable, second one is the method. What are all the variables I'm using? Model, color, brand. These are all the variables. What is the method I am using? Speed and size. Okay, so speed and size that can be computed. Okay, so computational part has been given with the method. And you could be able to see how I am differentiating for the objects. So what I am going to do, if I am going to access a car, if I am going to access the contents of the car, I can map it for Ertiga. I could be able to fix up a color. I could be able to make up a brand called Maruti. So that could be an object. That could be an Ertiga is an object of car. XUV 500, it could be an object of the corresponding car. Swift is a corresponding object of a car. See, if I want to name this model, color, brand, I need an object. So that object is being differentiated for this. So ultimately, what I could be able to convey, using an object, I could be able to access the contents of the class. That could be the proper definition for the object also. Okay. So that could be, for example, I want to access this method. What I will do? object dot speed, that's all. Object dot size. Ultimately, I could be able to access the methods of the class also. So that could be the skeptical explanation for classes and objects in Java. Still, I could penetrate on that. What could be the characteristics of the object? That we should be remember very clearly. So 3 points will talk about this object. So it represents the data of an object, right? It represents the data of an object. Here, what is the data for the cars that you could able to see? Ertiga, Maroon, Maruti. These are all the data for the corresponding object for the car one. Okay, car one, car two, car three. For car one, that could be the data. Okay. Behavior represents the behavior of such as deposit, withdraw. Nothing but behavior will talk about the methods, speed, size. So depending upon speed and size only, the car variety will, the car brand will get to be varying. That's what the behavior. Identity, it is used to internally by the JVM to identify each object uniquely. I will show you through size of operator that you are very familiar in C and C++. Size of operator. So if I am going to use that size of operator for my object, that you could able to come to know about what is the size of the object, as well as I have an operator called a instance of. That is also will check that whether this object belongs to this class or not, that I could able to find it out. Okay. How to create object? This is the way to create object. Car is the name of the class. C is the object. So car C equal to new car. So that's going to be my way of creating the object. So in C, what you will do? Car C semicolon. It's enough that you could able to create an object. But here you could able to do it in a proper sense. Car C equal to new car. Car is the name of the class. C represents the object. Okay. And also they want to differentiate here. Declaration and instantiation that they are going to do. Instantiation is nothing but the place that where they are allocating memory. And okay, that is what we have talked about, that variable. We talked about the variable, instance variable, right? So new car, that's the place where we are doing instantiation. Declaration alone means I have created an object, but I have not allocated memory for that. Okay. So if it need to be allocated with the memory, I have to use the keyword new. So to dynamically allocate a memory for an object that should be used in a class, that should be done through new keyword. So please remember that. Okay. So that's the main idea on this. Yes, this slide will talk more about what is the difference between object and class. Because there is no need to differentiate object and class. You must understand the functionality, right? I found some questions in online university question papers, but that question is something not reasonable. You cannot differentiate class and object. Both are like a sandwich. Okay, so you cannot able to differentiate. Both the sides are important. Already I have talked about you. That could be the coin, right? Two sides of a coin. So you could not be able to differentiate class and object. Both of them are necessary to have the complete object-oriented paradigm need to be involved in here. Okay. So object is going to serve as the instance of a class. But what about a class? It could serve as the blueprint. Okay. So object will be mapped with some real world objects that you could be able to see. Collection of those objects will come as a class. So object is a physical entity that you could be able to view it. Logical entity class is going to be that you cannot be able to see because it's like a data structure. Okay, class is like a data structure. So how many number of objects you want to create, you could be able to create that you could be able to see that animal. How many number of animals we have seen, how many number of cars we have seen. Okay, so but class that we have declared only once. So object that we could be able to allocate memory, for class we could not be able to allocate memory because composition of methods and variables only which will give the memory of the class. So the procedure to create the class that we have seen already. So using that keyword class that I could be able to create a class. So and the last point is very very important, right? What are all the ways to create an object? There are 4 ways are there. Using new keyword, new instance method, clone method, deserialization. These are all the 4 ways are there. Okay, we have seen what is new method. Even in the previous point, you could able to see employee OB equal to new employee. So that's what your the way of creating the object using new keyword. First method is over. rest of the three I will show you in corresponding topics, okay, because it cannot be introduced here. While I'm going to deal with shallow copying and deep copying, I will show you the method of clone, okay. New instance method that I will show you, new instance method and deserialization I will show you when we are going to work with multi-threading, okay. So that's something interesting to know about that. So there are four ways are there to create object in Java, but in class we have only one way, just using class keyword that I could be able to create a class. This could be the nature of class and object or features of class and object, but you could be able to take it in that sense. It's not like differentiating class and object, okay. But in analysis, if they have asked it like that, it is good to draw this table with all these 7 points, that they will fetch you a reasonable mark. Yes, now demonstration time. See, in the last session, Shamini ma'am have taught you 4 types of methods. First one is that, or first one or second one, depending upon your category. I don't have return type, I don't have argument. That's category one. Second one, I don't have return type, but I have an argument. It is type two. I have return type, but I don't have argument. The last category, I have an argument as well as I have a return type. So here you could be able to see that I have created a class, my class. So what I am doing, I am writing a function called area. I am writing a method called area. Within that area, what I am doing, I am computing area of square. So S equal to 5, it is computing side into side values available in A. The entire functionality is being called inside the class using object. So how I am creating the object, my class obj equal to new my class, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, semicolon, object is created. Using obj, I am accessing the area. So object is the one which is ready to access the contents of the class. Okay, so here the method, if I want to execute that method, because methods are standalone, I could not be able to execute as it is. So I need to access it, obj.area. By default, it will call it and it will get to be executed. That is your category one. Okay. Second category, that here you could be able to see, I am going to get my input, because if I need to pass an argument, already I have mentioned user-defined functions are standalone. It cannot be able to execute on your own. In that case, I have to get the input from the main. So here I am assigning the value to s equal to 5, int s equal to 5, that s is passed with that object.area of s. So object.area of s, that s of s value will be 5. That 5 will come to that function, 5 into 5, 25. Since we have called obj.area of s, ultimately it will give you the value 25. Okay, this is category 2, obj.area of s. Here no return type, but I have passed an argument. Third category. So here what I am doing, the same thing, I have created an object. Check that function first, public int area, because you have a return type. So I have declared a value 5, assigned a value 5 for side. I am computing area of square. So side into side, value will be stored in 5, A. Now instead of printing, I am returning it. That is the reason why I have given the keyword int. Why I am choosing that int as a return type? Because two integers while doing multiplication will result in an integer only. Okay. Because it will stick to the property of, it will stick to the property of, we forgot something on maths, right? We stick to the property of closure. Okay. So ultimately it will yield us an integer only. So an integer multiplied with an integer will give an integer only ultimately. So the return value will be received in an integer variable again. Okay, obj.area, because that area will return an integer value. Okay, here your function name will serve as the identifier. Okay, area will hold 25. The 25 will be stored in R. So ultimately I will get that value. R equal to 25. 25 be stored in R, and I'm going to print R. This is what my return type based one. So this is the final type that it will compose everything. It will compose everything. I'm getting a value side from main, passing it to that area of S. The 5 will come here, multiplied, 25 will be returned towards that area identifier that will be stored in R, that R will be displayed. So simple thing, I have created a class, I have created an object, I wrote my method, using the object I have accessed that method, that's all. It has to be demonstrated through your functions, that what you have learnt in the previous session. This is a simple class program. On all four categories you should be familiar, okay? Category 1, category 2, category 3 and category 4, okay? So that could be the major idea on this, okay? Now what's about your homework? Already we gave you a homework for writing the functions, okay? So our suggestion is, please upload your homework in your GitHub, okay? In your own GitHub, you create a repository called Java homework, okay? Java homework. Within that, what are all the homeworks that we are giving, you upload it, okay? We will share a Excel file with you. You post your GitHub profile link. We teachers visit your profile link and see whether you wrote your program correctly or not. If you have any comments, that the respective teacher will talk to you through the group, okay? So today's homework. So here I wrote here I wrote area of square by using four categories of methods, using the concept of class and object, as well as what is encapsulation, the process of binding data with the code. Data is these variables, and this variable and values are being mapped with the corresponding method. That's what encapsulation also, okay? So the process of class, object, encapsulation are being taught here through area of square. The same four programs that you need to repeat with addition of two numbers, okay? Using this class you have to write addition of two numbers, using class as well as these four categories of methods you have to repeat. So you have to write four programs for addition of two numbers. So any queries and clarifications, please post me in the chat. I want to listen to your clarifications in the chat. Please post your contents on the chat. Waiting for your clarifications. This classification time is very important, right? You can post something that other students also are ready to ask the doubt, that they must be hesitating to ask. So better you can post that doubts.